As the old cliche goes, the best camera is the one that you have with you. With regular gimbals, they're chunky, weigh quite a bit. Whenever I use them, it's usually with a planned shot. I'm not carrying it around with me just to get a spur of the moment B-roll. That's where something like this comes in handy. A camera with lots of potential that fits nicely in your hand, but just to make sure you're maximizing the potential of your Osmo Pocket, here are some creative tips or tricks or ideas that won't break the bank. Let's go. It might be teeny tiny and cost less than dedicated gimbals plus cameras, but it doesn't mean that you should think that this is limited in functionality. Take the Infinity Roll feature of the Ronin S. Cool feature that makes the camera roll, obviously. Nice and easy to do, but with the Osmo Pocket, there isn't any feature to do that as such. It's not part of the software, there's no switch to flick, but you can do it, and you can do it quite easily, even when you're filming yourself. All you need is something solid to hold the Osmo Pocket up with. A posh plastic box will do, but the accessory mount is useful. Another useful bit of posh plastic makes it easier to mount with the standard action camera mount accessories. Then you mount it like you would have it in flashlight mode, put the wireless module on, you have to buy that also, sorry, and you connect it with your phone using the Mimo app. This is how you do the 360 roll while filming yourself. You face the camera forwards, have it roll to one side, and then walk and push the opposite direction that you've just rolled it to. That's it. The simplicity of it makes it seem almost daft, but you can get some great camera movement out of something as affordable as the Osmo Pocket. And if you're all about B-rolls and transitions, it can make for a smooth transition. There is another way of doing it that seems even easier, and that's by using FPV mode, first person view. Basically, it'll follow your movements, so you can do this. You kind of have to use both hands, really, or you use it like this. Hang on, I'm trying to figure out how to do this. No, you kind of have to hand it over to the other hand to do the full 360. How about if I do it like that? Woo! Went mental there, but it's harder to get a nice, smooth 360 roll compared to the method that I pointed out just now. It is quite hard to keep the subject centered with this method. These things will be quite popular with vloggers, and at first you might be tempted to use the follow mode and track your face because it does work quite well. It's more attracted to your face than most other people are, but personally, I wouldn't use this mode. I'd use FPV mode. Why? Face track on, it's tracking my face. Sometimes it will lose your face. There you go, it's lost my face. And what happens? What happens when it loses your face? You kind of have to, there you go. Subject tracking is pretty reliable, but if you put all your faith in it, you're expecting it to do wonders. And if you're using the screen on the Osmo Pocket, which is quite tiny, you might not realize when your face has slipped out of frame. And then you just have to kind of stop your vlog for a minute and track your face again. That's why I think it's better to just use FPV mode. With the FPV mode, it stays where you're pointing it, and when you're holding a four-sided object like this, you don't always need to look at the camera to know which direction you're pointing it in. You can feel it. Look, you can vlog with your eyes closed, although that would be a bit douchey. And you might want to switch the camera around to film something that you're talking about, and I think it's easy in FPV mode. Look, back to yourself, back to that, instead of clicking this button three times. I've got nothing majorly against the three clicks method, it's just a little bit slow to turn around than simply flicking it around. It's super light, which you already know. Utilize that, stick it to things that you wouldn't a normal size camera. Here are a couple of ideas to get you started. Thanks to a butchered selfie stick and some elastic bongo ties, I made a Snorri cam, refer to movie Requiem for a Dream if you don't know what that is. But you will look like an utter knob running around like that. Yes, it's not the coolest look in the world, but you can get some hands-free action without breaking the bank for a Snorri, even if you do look like you've got a Robocock erection. The second idea is using your kids' toy cars as a dolly. Right, let's talk accessories. Right, now when you want to have a clearer idea of what you're filming, use the app, the Mimo app. However, having just that lightning connector to hold everything together is just asking for trouble. Something is gonna break. In fact, I can show you something that had a lightning connector. I had past tense because it's broken. This Rode Video Mic Mi L broke. Look, didn't even do anything. I just literally farted at it and then broke. Anyway, the point I'm getting at is use one of those phone holder things, and I recommend, hashtag not an ad, the PGY Tech one, because it's all metal and doesn't feel like it'll break easy. It has a conventional tripod mount and a cold shoe, and you don't have to worry about your phone snapping off. It just makes it a more balanced setup, plus it makes a good vlogging setup. Really do accessorize with the Osmo Pocket. If you don't want to get too many things, get ND filters. It's a must have if you want to stick with that golden 180 degree shutter rule, or you just want to control your exposure manually in daylight. Also, get the phone holder, as I mentioned before, the wireless module, the accessory mount, because if you want to use a selfie stick, mini tripod, bike mount, whatever, a whole load of other accessories, you need to use this. The controller wheel thing, so you can control pan and tilt. In fact, just get the DJI kit, but it comes with all three of those things I just mentioned. But if you're serious about video, although the inbuilt mic is surprisingly good, you might want to add your own audio. In fact, you will want to add your own audio. DJI doesn't have any 3.5mm inputs here, but they've got an adapter, which I can't show you because I don't have one, but this will allow you to add your own mic with an adapter, 3.5mm, to one of these USB-C. Yeah, I don't have the DJI one, but I've got one of these cheapo 3.5mm to USB-C adapters, which is just a cable. So it's a cable attached to another cable, which is a little bit messy, but the DJI one is a lot tidier, but of course it costs more. Hello, hello, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, this is the Rode Video Mic. Video micro from Rode. If you're fine with an internal mic, make sure you're not going to cover it with your hand. It's on the bottom. You can even shield the rear of it if you want to help pick up less sounds from the rear, and you can get some surprisingly good audio from the internal mic. Right, so this is the sound straight from the DJI Osmo Pocket. So there we are. I think the Osmo Pocket has so much potential creative goodness, all out of something that slips easily into your bag, or maybe your pocket. Bush, there we are. Hope it was helpful, as always, and hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. See ya.